I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Santina and Reed here with your morning announcements for September 27, 2018.
Today's lunch is meatball mozzarella hoagie, steamed carrot coins, and diced pears.
Attention all students, Spirit Week shirts will be on sale this Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday during both lunch periods in the cafeteria. Shirts are $10 for sizes small through extra large, $11 for size extra large, and $12 for extra, extra, extra large. Cash and checks made out to CVHS are accepted forms of payment.
Students may check in and check out books in the library on Tuesdays and Thursdays during academic cycle. Students need to have a pass from the academic cycle teacher prior to entering the library.
Any ninth grade boys wishing to play basketball this year, there will be a sign-up sheet in the office this week. Open gym is every Monday at 6:30, Tuesday at 3:15, and Thursday at 6.
If you would like to be a member of the French, German, or Spanish clubs, please pay $3 by Friday, September 28th, to your respective language teacher. You are eligible to be a member of a language club if you are presently taking a language or you have done so at some point in your high school career.
Girls Powder Puff signups are underway. Any girls are interested, please contact Jaden Frasinelli by October 5th. The tournament will be held in late October to early November.
All 11th grade students are mandated by the state of Pennsylvania to have a physical. All the necessary paperwork was mailed over the summer to your home address. Please return the forms provided and signed by your doctor to the school nurse.
There will be a gymnastics informational meeting on Thursday, October 4th at 6:30 p.m. at the Monaca Turner's Dining Hall. Anyone interested in high school gymnastics should attend this meeting. Please sign up at the main office or the athletic director's office if you're interested in joining the team.
It's never too late to sign up for FBLA. Election of officers will take place this Friday afternoon. Only paid members are eligible to run for office and vote for officers. Pay your $20 dues to Ms. DeLon in NA 202 before noon on Friday. Cash or checks are acceptable.
Central Valley will hold the 8th annual Warriors in Pink observance during the varsity football game versus Aliquippa on Friday, October 26th. The pink ribbon is an international symbol of breast cancer, and Warriors in Pink is CV Juniors Lauren Kostowski, Liz Brobeck, Maddie Schultz, and Diana Huber's senior project to bring about breast cancer awareness.
As part of the event, Warriors in Pink t-shirts are being sold, as well as pink luminaries, which will be lit in honor or memory of a loved one diagnosed with a disease. Order forms can be found in the athletic office, main high school office, or downloaded from the athletics page on the school website.
If you know a survivor who is interested in participating in our halftime ceremony, please see Ms. Koppel in the high school athletic office for information.
That concludes your announcements today, CV. Have a great day.
Hey, CV, it's Nico and Isaac here with your sports.
Yesterday, the tennis team won, and Mara Thompson-Wright and Brooke Burhan will be playing in the WPIL qualifying match for the Section AA. Good luck, girls.
Girls golf defeated Elwood City.
Boys soccer team won 1-0. The goal was scored by Tyler Wilson and assisted by John Swatola.
Girls soccer lost to West Allegheny 3-1.
Boys soccer faces Quaker Valley tonight at home at 7:30.
The volleyball team takes on Mars at home at 7:30.
That's all of the sports coverage for today, CV. Have a great day.
Hello, CV. Today we're going to be talking about iPhone addiction. Some of you may have this and not know. Stay tuned to learn more. If you have any of these things listed, you may be suffering from iPhone addiction. 1. You spend more and more time on your phone to get the same effect. 2. You feel strange when you don't have your phone. 3. You can't stop yourself from using the phone even if you don't want to. 4. You think you hear it ring when it really didn't. 5. You can't operate a vehicle without using it. 6. You have trouble doing normal day things without it. And lastly, here's how Apple wants to help you with your problem.
Apple wants to break your iPhone addiction? Apple has just announced a slate of new updates coming in iOS 12 designed to help you kick your addiction to your phone. First off, if you can't stop looking at your phone when you're trying to fall asleep, the new Do Not Disturb feature can set hours when you won't receive notifications from apps. You can customize which hours and which apps, so if you want, you'll still receive calls and texts, but not creepy late night DMs from Instagram. And if you want to guilt yourself into using your phone less, Apple announced the ability to look at all the advanced data on how much you're actually on your device. Finally, if you need a last line of defense to keep yourself or a kid or a loved one off a device, you can set time limits on specific apps that will lock the program when your time is up. It might be the easiest way to keep yourself from endlessly scrolling through Twitter and Facebook. That's all for Relevant News. For more, you can follow us on Twitter at Relevant or visit our website at relevantmagazine.com.
Hello, Central Valley. Today, I'm interviewing John. So I have a few questions for you. Mm-hmm. How much time do you think you spend on your phone?
More than I'd like to.
Like, on the daily?
Yeah, probably more than I'd like to. If I could, I'd probably cut my phone off totally, but, you know.
Kind of impossible
nowadays.
So do you believe in iPhone addiction?
For sure.
Do you think you're addicted?
I wouldn't say I'm addicted because if I wanted to stop, I could, but in a sense, I guess you could say it's kind of controlling, for sure, yeah.
Okay, thank you. In conclusion, cell phones definitely have created a more connected world, but at the same time, face-to-face communication has suffered from phone screen addiction. Research shows there are physical concerns with overuse of cell phones, such as eye strains and neck issues, known as text neck. Lastly, there has been much research concerning mental health issues from the use of cell phones and social media, such as anxiety, which is a major issue due to the constant need for instant gratification and checking for notifications, as well as the perception on social media of other leading the perfect life, which can increase anxiety and depression. Phone addiction is a major issue for sleep disturbances. It has been linked to an increase in sleep disorders and fatigue. Do not text and drive. As we know, it is legal and the cause of thousands of motor accidents.